Have you ever wondered what 3 million hectares looks like? Meet the Brook family, Australia's first organic beef producers and part of OB Organic, raising and grazing cattle the old-fashioned way and the way nature intended.
Growing up in Birdsville in the middle of the outback, you certainly appreciate what you have, but you probably appreciate more what you don't have. My name's Anthony Brook. I'm a fourth generation Brook. We've been living around Birdsville for the best part of 100 years. We're beef producers. I'm pretty lucky to be doing what I do. I get to be in the outback every day. Your work is part of who you are, and you often don't really consider it work.
One of the most incredible opportunities you can have as a chef is to be able to come out to places like OB Organic and meet the faces behind the produce. One of the biggest icons in Birdsville is Big Red. It's like, oh yeah, that's on our property. And they drive past it every day. You've got this amazing contrast between the red earth and then these insane green pastures. But to them, it's just another day at the office.
Living and working on these properties, definitely a lifestyle. You have to embrace a few of the old ways, and that might be camping in your swag, under the stars, getting ready for a muster, getting up early, collecting the cattle. Sometimes you have helicopters helping, sometimes you have the plane. People say, what did you have to do to become organic? Well, we didn't do anything. We were always that way. We have very few fences, so the cattle are able to roam freely, exhibit all their natural behaviour that they would in an environment where we weren't around. There's a whole supply chain that makes AB Beef what it is, and you end up with a product that I think people appreciate. We're always looking for customers that line up with what we're doing. You know, Three Blue Ducks, they're into their sustainability, so that's a perfect fit. They can tell their customer our story.
You walk away with an incredible feeling inside, knowing that these cattle are in the best hands.
I suppose in 100 years' time, I would hope that my family's still here and nothing's changed. People say, well, why would you want to live in Birdsville? And I say, why wouldn't you?